Good evening. Thank you very much, Alexandra, the very kind remarks. I have known her for a long time, but I'm very honored that Vince's best friend is with us tonight, Mr. Alex Dillard. I know how much he loved you and cherished the friendship that you had. Congratulations, Debbie Ferrée and Kevin Donahue. We're fortunate to have leaders like you in the industry. And I would like to thank the 210 organization for honoring Vince. It's a very special, special honor to accept this for him. You do such important work and you really care, and that is making all the difference. I know Vince would have been humbled to be here tonight. He was never one to seek out the spotlight, and he rarely spoke about what he did for others. He was an extraordinary force in our industry, and he inspired so many with his warmth and the passionate style. That smile and that glint in his eyes is what we will always remember about him. I was taken by the similarities between T. Kenyon Holly, this award, and Vince. They both worked quietly and on behalf of others. They did good things, but not for public recognition. They stayed under the radar. But because it was the right thing to do, and this was very much like Vince. Vince always took an interest in helping people around him, and his acknowledgement truly speaks to the man he was. Whether it was shoe lines, or building companies, or motivating people to do their best, he always led by example. I remember a few years ago, we were about five of us in Vince's office one night. We were all working late, and we were looking at what is our next ad campaign going to be. So we had tear sheets spread out all over his desk, and Vince said, you know, forget about this. I would like to have a tiger. And we were like, what? You want to have a tiger? What are you talking about? I said, and he said with conviction, no, I want to have a tiger and a girl. And that is what our company was very much about. Vince had an idea, and we did it. So after the tiger, we had a horse. And it was lots of great ideas. So, he had an incredible sense of what was happening globally. He knew what if a trend was happening in Dubai, or in Hong Kong, or in New York, it was all happening at the same time, and that was Vince's genius. He loved trend. Vince said, spent his time mentoring so many of us, even here tonight, me included, and I'm, of course, forever grateful. But his generosity of spirit and hardworking can-do attitude continuously inspired us. He pushed us to be our best selves and could always see our greatest potential. His story is a great example of the American dream. If you work hard and have passion for what you do and believe in yourself, you can achieve your goals. Like his mother always used to tell him, you can do anything you set your mind to. We are all better having known him. As I am here tonight with his children, it's a very special moment for us. I loved him deeply, and he was an incredible husband, father, and friend, and an inspiring leader. With great integrity, who lives on in each of us every day. I thank you on his behalf for this wonderful honor, and I know Vince would be saying to all of us, keep working hard, doing good, and building up the people around you. Continue to live with passion. Thank you.